Hello and welcome to this video. Today, I'll show you how to set up a local virtual assistant that can teach you literally anything and it will be fast and local. We'll use the DeepSeek R11.5 billion model, which is the smallest and fastest model available. You can run this on any PC. Additionally, we'll use Open Web UI to provide a user-friendly interface. As you can see in the address bar, we're running this locally. What I mean by a virtual assistant is a tool that can help you learn anything, from coding to business skills. Let me give you a quick demo. If I click on the button, I'll be able to interact with DeepSeek R1 in a text-to-speech format. So let's try it out. I click the button and say, "Hello, I want to learn how to set up a small print-on-demand business from scratch. Can you please teach me step-by-step how to start and what investments I might need? I'm a beginner and have no idea how to start." Now, you can see it's thinking. The DeepSeek R1 model is processing my request. Soon, it will respond with a detailed step-by-step guide. It's going to start talking as soon as it finishes its thinking process.
To set up a print-on-demand business, follow this organized plan based on your considerations. 1. Research and planning. Target audience, identify potential customers, people interested in home decor, greeting cards, etc. Unique selling point, develop a distinct product offering to differentiate from competitors. 2. Opening the store, if you choose one. Physical space setup, if possible, rent or lease space and hire an assistant for management. Inventory management, create detailed lists with product details, quantity, size, color, in your online presence. 3. Marketing strategy. Social media and blog, use platforms like Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube to showcase products and engage customers. Content creation, develop a blog or YouTube channel for educational content on printing. 4. Promotions and sales. Limited time sales, offer discounts during events or holidays. Seasonal sales.
So, you see how it works? It's all set up locally, meaning you don't have to rely on any payment plans or cloud services. Even if you don't have internet access, you can still use this setup. I really love this kind of setup, and today I'll show you how to set it up. If you want to set up something like this, keep watching this video. Also, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe for more content like this. The very first thing we need to do is install Docker. Go to docker.com and download it. Docker supports Mac, Windows, and Linux, so download the version that matches your operating system. After downloading, install Docker and then run it. Okay, the first step is to run Docker. For example, I'm running Docker here, and you can see it's running. After you do that, make sure Docker is running smoothly. I'll provide the links for these URLs in the description. The second thing you need to do is ensure that Olama is installed on your computer. Go to olama.com, the link is in the description, download and install it. Make sure Olama is running as well. Both Docker and Olama need to be running for this setup to work. Next, you need to go to this link, copy it, and paste it into the command prompt, cmd. Here's how. Open cmd, paste the copied link, and press enter. However, I would suggest checking the port number. The port number is essential because it specifies where the web UI is running. In my case, I am running the web UI on port 5000. If you're using this port for something else, you might encounter an error. Therefore, if you face any issues, change the port number to something else to avoid conflicts. Make sure you have the correct port number and that both Docker and Olama are running without any errors. If everything is set up correctly, you should be able to access the web UI and start using your local virtual assistant to learn and create projects efficiently. So, what you can do is open Notepad, paste the command here, and change the port number. Copy the modified command, then come back to CMD, remove the previous command, or open a new CMD window and paste the updated command here. Run it. I'm not going to run it because I've already installed everything, but just in case you face any issues, feel free to let me know in the comment section. Once you run this command, it will install some necessary packages and download the required Docker image. Afterward, check your Docker settings. You should see the image listed under the web UI. Additionally, make sure you've configured Olama correctly. Go to Olama, navigate to Models, and click on DeepSeek R1. Ensure you've installed the 1.5 billion model, which is the smallest and fastest option. Here's how you can verify. Copy the command again, go back to your command prompt, paste it, and press Enter. In my case, since I've already installed it, you can see it's ready to go. If you haven't installed it yet, the command will download the model, and once it's done, you'll receive a confirmation message indicating that it has been installed. For example, if you type hi, it should respond, confirming that everything is set up correctly. If you type bye, it will close the session. This is how you install and verify everything. To recap, here's what you need to do. Go to docker.com, download, and install Docker on your system. Go to olama.com, download and install Olama. Navigate to Models, select DeepSeek R1, and then choose the 1.5 billion model. Copy the installation command and paste it into your command prompt. Following these steps will ensure everything is set up correctly, and you'll be ready to use your local virtual assistant efficiently. After running the command, hit Enter. Once it's installed, the third thing you need to do is go to the website I've linked in the description. You can either copy the command from the description or try the alternative command that supports NVIDIA GPU, especially if you're facing issues with a different port. For example, if the initial command doesn't work, try this one if you have an NVIDIA GPU. These commands vary based on your operating system and whether you have Olama installed. If you face any issues, please let me know in the comment section and I'll help you troubleshoot. After running the command, you'll get an address. Click on that address and you'll see a link similar to this one. This is a local setup, so even though you need to create an account, your information remains secure. You can use a dummy email and password for security. For example, you can use something like something@something.com and a password like password. Once you've signed up, you'll be ready to go. Remember, this is a local setup, so your information is safe and no one else will have access to it. After signing in, you'll see the interface. Since I've already signed up, it's asking me to log in. But for you, it will be a different link. Once you sign up and log in, everything will be local and you can start using the virtual assistant. Now, let's see how it works. I'll create a new chat and type, "Hello, how are you doing today? I want to learn how to code a website with Lovable. Is Lovable the future, or should I learn how to code from scratch? What would you pick if you were in my place?" It's processing now, and this model is very fast.
Based on the thought process and considerations, here's an organized approach to learning web development. 1. Start with foundations. Begin with HTML and CSS. These form the basic structure of a website, allowing you to create simple, user-friendly interfaces without needing JavaScript yet. 2. Learn as you go. Use online courses and tutorials to learn JavaScript at your own pace. Focus on understanding fundamental concepts like...
Sometimes, Lovable might misunderstand, but since this is a local setup, it's not searching anything online. It's a very quick tool if you want to learn how to code or need quick answers without sharing your data with large companies. You can download and use it locally, ensuring your privacy. If you face any issues with the setup, feel free to let me know in the comment section. Another great feature of this tool is that you can record your voice. I haven't tested this yet, but it seems like a good opportunity to try it out. Let's see how it works. I'll click on Record Voice and say, "Hello, how are you doing? Can you please write me an essay on anything? Thank you very much." After clicking Yes, it's actually recognizing my voice in TypeScript. Wow, that's impressive. For example, if I want to say something longer, like, "Hello, I want to learn how to code, but I don't know where to start. Can you please help me with that? I would be very grateful if you can help me. I love coding, and I know there are AI tools out there that can produce code very quickly and efficiently. But for some reason, I still want to learn to code. I think it's a valuable skill because, in the end, who will test out the AI-generated code? What if there's a problem and the AI can't resolve it? I believe I can improve with time, but I still think knowing how to code is important. Maybe I can even build my own AI systems or something. What are your thoughts on this? Let's see how it responds. I think it's crucial to learn coding because, despite the advancements in AI, human oversight and understanding remain invaluable. Knowing how to code allows you to build your own solutions and troubleshoot effectively. AI is great, but learning to code is still important for long-term growth and innovation. All right, this tool is very handy. You can actually record your voice and it converts it to text, which you can then send to the AI, Open Web UI, and now it's going through the thinking process. Because text-to-speech is turned off, it's not speaking back, but you can click on Read Audio to hear the response. You'll see options like Response Tokens, Continue Response, and Regenerate Continue Response. This is all happening locally, and it's very fast. You can speak with DeepSeek Carbon and even hear it read aloud. It's like having a virtual assistant right on your PC. This is an amazing tool, especially if you love AI. I highly recommend installing it on your PC or laptop. If I listen to the current response, it details the reasoning process.
Details type equals reasoning done equals true duration equals 10. Summary thought for 10 seconds slash summary. All right, so I want to learn how to code and start building my own website. Where do I even begin? I'm a bit overwhelmed by all the terms and concepts floating around. Let's see. There's HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Yeah, those are the big ones. But wait, what exactly is HTML? Is it just for creating websites on the web? And how does that relate to coding? Maybe I should start with the basics. I've heard of HTML being the language of the web. So maybe it's like a set of rules.
Now it's reading the thinking process. This is the reasoning model at work. It's thinking about what to answer. It's not just spitting out responses. It's genuinely considering the best way to help you. This is a very powerful tool, and I can't praise it enough. The only thing I'd say is that I wish for better text-to-speech integration. Ideally, something like Kokoro text-to-speech, which is free to use, would enhance the quality of the voice output. I've already made a video on it, and I'll find a way to implement it. So instead of the current mediocre text-to-speech voice, we can have a higher quality one. If that happens, it will be wonderful. If you like this video and found it helpful, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. This motivates me to create even more content and videos. I truly appreciate the engagement, and it helps me know what topics to cover next. Leave a comment if you have any issues or questions, and don't forget to give a like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video, and thank you.